Missing flight MH370 relatives told to return home. Malaysia Airlines has asked relatives of passengers on board flight MH370 to leave the hotel accommodation it is providing and return to their homes. It is closing the family assistance centers set up after the plane vanished on March 8 with 239 people on board. The airline promised to keep relatives up to date on the search operation. Meanwhile, a report by Malaysia's Transport Ministry has recommended the introduction of real-time tracking of commercial air transport. The ministry's Air Accident Investigation Bureau said there had now been two occasions over the past 5 years when large passenger planes had gone missing and their last position was not accurately known. MH370 and Air France Flight 447 in 2009. This uncertainty resulted in significant difficulty in locating the aircraft in a timely manner, the report noted. There is no requirement from the International Civil Aviation Authority ICAO, the UN body that oversees global aviation, for real-time tracking. Transport Minister Hishamuddin Hussein also released for the first time the recordings of conversations between MH370's pilots and air traffic controllers. A transcript was published earlier this month. The plane's cargo manifest and seating plan was also published by Mr. Hussein, along with a summary of events from the disappearance of the plane's radar blip until activation of the Rescue Coordination Center. Prolonged process. MH370 disappeared while flying from Kuala Lumpur to Beijing. The search initially took place in the South China Sea and the Malacca Straits, but moved to the southern Indian Ocean after about 3 weeks when satellite data was reanalyzed. No wreckage from the plane has been found, and an aerial search of the ocean 1,670 kilometers northwest of the Australian city of Perth ended on Monday. An unmanned submarine is continuing to search a 314 square kilometers 121 square mile area of the ocean floor where acoustic signals consistent with a plane's flight recorder were detected earlier this month. On Thursday, Malaysia Airlines said in a statement, despite such an intensified search operation, probably the largest one in human history, we have to face the hard reality that there is still no trace of the aircraft, and the fate of the missing passengers and crew remains unknown. Malaysia Airlines is acutely conscious of, and deeply sympathetic to the continuing unimaginable anguish, distress and hardship suffered by those with loved ones on board the flight. But it warned that the continuing search and investigation would probably be a prolonged process and that it would be adjusting the mode of services and support for the relatives. Instead of staying in hotels, the families of MH370 are advised to receive information updates on the progress of the search and investigation and other support by Malaysia Airlines within the comfort of their own homes, with the support and care of their families and friends. All family assistance centers would be closed on May 7, but the relatives would be given news updates through telephone calls, messages, the internet and face-to-face meetings, Malaysia Airlines said. Centers will be established in the capitals of Malaysia and China, where most of those on board MH370 were from, to provide follow-up support and services. The families have been critical of the initial search process and the way they have been kept informed. Many have told the BBC that they believe Malaysian officials know more than they are revealing. Last week, 10 Malaysia Airlines staff were reportedly held against their will for more than 10 hours at a hotel in Beijing by angry relatives. Malaysia Airlines also said it would soon make advanced compensation payments to their nominated next of kin, in order to meet their immediate economic needs. The payments would not affect their rights to claim further compensation at a later stage, it added.